This is the moment the clock starts ticking on a mango. From here, the race is on to get them treated, dried, sold, transported, sold again, and eaten before they spoil. The problem is, most mangoes don't make it this far. In fact, most don't even make it to store shelves or markets like this. This is a problem we face with a lot of our food. In India alone, billions of dollars worth of food every year doesn't reach customers in time, while millions go hungry. So, what if there was a way to slow the clock down? Mangoes are the national fruit of India, and most of them come from here, the mango mecca, if you will. About 300,000 tons of mangoes are produced in the Krishnagiri district, shipped across the country and the world. But the harvest period is short, and farmers work around the clock from May to July. That's because the fruit spoils easily, and margins are thin. But on this farm, some relief has come in the form of a spray.
So the point in which you had to stop the spray is after complete soaking of the fruit started dripping the formulation. That is an indication that you can stop spraying.
This is K.S. Subramanian. For over a decade, he and a team of researchers from Canada and Sri Lanka have developed a chemical solution that could extend the life of a fruit or vegetable simply by spraying it on its surface, before or after harvest.
For 10 liters of water, 200 ml of formulation to be used.
There's been other efforts to extend the shelf life of fruits by coating them with wax and other materials. This one is a spray containing a compound called hexanal, which naturally occurs in many plants.
When you bite a cucumber, this compound is produced. When the grass is mowed, you get a smell.
Hexanal that seeps into the skin can slow down the ripening process. Subramanian and his team have worked with thousands of farmers in the region over the last decade, testing the spray on over 100,000 hectares of mango plantations. Their results showed that treated mangoes lasted for around a week longer than the ones that weren't treated. Because of this, the spray would save around 10% of each harvest. That's about 100 kilos of mangoes per tree per year.
This one is sprayed, so it has good quality. This is untreated, which is clearly seen, this will be rejected in the market.
Farmers are allowed to sell these treated mangoes locally because of an approval from Tamil Nadu's Department of Agriculture. Apart from tackling food losses, the solution could mean they don't have to rush to sell their mangoes at the wholesale market.
There is a glut in the market in a particular season. The mango price goes down to 10 to 15 rupees a kilo. If you delay by 2 weeks only, it goes up to 100 rupees. There is a jump in the price. That is why this technology is promoted at the later part of the season. This is a regional laboratory where the mango analysis are done.
Subramanian's team has tested the hexanal formulation on other crops on farms from Sri Lanka to Kenya. And the results have shown it's been able to keep other fruits like bananas and strawberries fresher compared to non-treated ones. The big question now is whether they can get permission to sell it in India and around the world. And there's a lot at stake, not just for farmers, but all of us.
So it's early morning here in Mumbai, and we're at one of the main wholesale vegetable and fruit markets here. And people have been here since about 3 a.m., selling any kind of vegetable and fruit that you can imagine.
Some arrive damaged, others aren't sold by the time the market wraps up, and the leftovers pile up pretty fast. Globally, Around 13% of food is lost in this way each year, but that number is far higher in places like sub-Saharan Africa and South Asia. It's not just a food security problem. Food waste contributes as much as 10% of all greenhouse gas emissions. If it were a country, it'd be the third biggest emitter, behind the US and China.
And that happens at every level of the supply chain, from markets like this one, all the way down to the moment that crops are harvested.
The most straightforward solution is to refrigerate products along every step of the supply chain. But in India, cold storage is out of reach for many small-scale farmers because of the upfront investment and high energy costs to keep them running.
Is refrigeration the solution? I don't think so. I think we need to look at multiple solutions.
That's where coatings and sprays come in as potentially cheaper, more accessible alternatives to cold storage. Wax coatings have been around for decades. They delay ripening by offering protection against mold, bruising during transport, and they've been recognized as safe for consumption. In the last few years, there's also been the rise of plant-based alternatives produced by companies like Appeal. But different coating formulas have to be created for different fruits. And getting the Hexanal spray off the ground has been challenging for its own reasons.
The key challenge is that it's a long process. We're not talking weeks or months. These are generally, it takes years.
Terrence Park is the CEO of Peak Harvest. A former investment banker, he ran a tech-focused hedge fund in Canada until he saw an opportunity to commercialize the spray. A few years ago, Peak Harvest licensed the formula from Subramanian and his team. And it's the only company at the moment that's trying to make the spray profitable. They're betting that Canada will be the first country where the spray could be approved. It's where the researchers are in advanced talks with regulators and agricultural product distributors. Authorities there haven't been able to decide whether to regulate Hexanal formulation as a fertilizer, or a pesticide, or something else altogether.
This is such a unique technology that solves a lot of problems, but it's also been challenging because there's really nothing like it in the industry today.
The company's own research has concluded that its Hexanal product isn't harmful for animals or humans. But so far, no outside studies on the product's health impacts have been conducted on it. Approval from the Food Safety Standards Authority of India is required before the mangoes are sold nationally. Park says that could help address any customer concerns as well.
The biggest reservation would be, what are you doing to our crop? Is it genetically modified?
Until Hexanal gets approval across India, some farmers are receiving it for free. But with an expected sticker price of around 800 rupees or about $10 per liter, it's out of reach for many of them. The average mango farmer in Krishnagiri makes the equivalent of around $20 per mango tree. And 10% of that? Would have to go towards the spray.
இந்த ஒரு பாட்டில் திரவம் வந்து 800 ரூபாயோ நான் விக்கிறோம். எவ்வளவு உங்களால அஃபோர்ட் பண்ண முடியும்?
கடிக்கும் போது அது அதிகமான பிரைஸ் ஆகுது.
பிரைஸ் ஆகுது.
ஆமா.
சார் குறைந்த விலைக்கு நான் விலை வந்து குறைச்சி இவ்வளவு தான் கிடைக்கும்னு சொல்ல. அது வந்து நல்ல குறைந்த விலைக்கு விவசாயிகள் கிடைக்கிறதுக்கான வழிவகை செஞ்சா
400 ரூபாய்க்கு கிடைக்கும்.
ஆ நல்லா இருக்கு.
Our idea is to price this competitively. So for a grower, for them to consider refrigeration and other real hard capital costs, I think that our solution will be extremely attractive relative to those other alternatives.
Even with regulatory approval and a lower price point, the Hexanal spray and others like it are just one piece of a puzzle in solving the food loss problem.
Examples like these are definitely important, but we also need to work on reducing other barriers as well, like how we're packaging and how are you storing the food.
In the meantime, Subramanian sees its potential everywhere.
This is one of the dumping sites in which how the mangoes are wasted is obviously seen. If the Hexanal technology is known to them, the entire lot could be a valuable mangoes.
Thanks for watching this video. We're actually on our way to Indonesia where we're filming the last two episodes of Rerooted. And I want to know, is there anything you want to see or know about the future of crops? Let us know in the comments below and subscribe to our channel.